The transition to a new sustainable development model must be consistent with the best available science and in line with the Paris Agreement and the Sustainable Development Goals towards an economy that delivers well-being for all within the planetary boundaries. So the European semester is now rightly being reformed to monitor progress towards the Sustainable Development Goals. This reform needs to be supported by the development of robust and meaningful metrics and indicators fit for the 21st century. Indeed, it's time we move beyond the GDP, an outdated and insufficient indicator that is not only unfit for the transition, but actually hampers it. The need to reform the European semester highlights the elephant in the room, the Stability and Growth Pact, the implementation of which the European semester actually monitors. A green recovery, the implementation of the Green Deal in a way that does justice to the millions of Europeans already left behind. The imperative to build back better requires nothing less than a new sustainable development pact to replace the existing stability and growth pact, to abandon the previous orthodoxies of fiscal austerity and market deregulation and enable us to build back better, that is, increase well-being for all while we decrease inequalities and combat global warming, biodiversity loss and environmental pollution. This new pact must not increase debt pressure on member states and must discount climate change mitigation, adaptation, and social cohesion expenditure from the calculation of member state budget deficits. The Sustainable Development Pact must give us the fighting chance to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals entirely and indivisibly by 2030. We must make sure that we have learned the lesson of the pandemic and understand that the only way to build back better is to make peace with nature. In establishing the Recovery and Resilience Facility, we broke a couple of taboos. I hope you agree that if we are to deliver this transition, it's time to break the big taboo and reform the Stability and Growth Pact itself. Thank you.
In this context, I think it is important to underline what many have said, and also Mr. Kokkalis has said in all clarity. His was more of a declaration, not a question, but what he said is right. We need to revisit Stability and Growth Pact in light of the new conditions. Now, I also want to be very clear. This doesn't mean no reforms, no rules, spend whatever you like, but it does mean we have to look at what growth is in the context of two new factors in our economy. You know, always our economy was based, analysis of growth was always based on two production factors, labor and capital. I would argue that now we have to look at four production capitals at least, apart from labor and capital. We need to look at data. Data has become an incredible production factor, and our citizens very often are not aware of the wealth they have in their hands with data. Anyway, something we need to look at, and we're working on that. And of course, the fourth one, which I call Gaia, which are the planetary boundaries within which we live. And if we introduce those two on a equal footing with labor and capital, then we can redefine what true well-being is, true growth is, true wealth is. And I think this is what we need to do in the time to come. And the Commission is very much willing to do that. Now, a specific question was asked also on coal mining. By the way, before I forget, Mr. Kokkalis, congratulations on Olympiakos's 4-2 win over PSV Eindhoven. Let's see if it sticks this week. Sorry for the unrelated matter. I needed to say that. I know he's a big supporter.